Welcome into the Jets 2-Minute Drill. Eric Allen inside the BetMGM studio, joined by Anthony Beck, as always. Anthony, the Jets fall to 0-4 on the season with a 37-28 loss to the Denver Broncos. It looked for a moment there like the green and white were going to secure a come-from-behind victory, but it was the Broncos who had the final answers in this one.
Yeah, you know, you're right. It was a crazy game, ups and downs. It was really a fun game to watch, but a lot of things, right, happened in the game that, you know, the Jets needed to take advantage of. You know, first and foremost, I thought Sam brought some excitement tonight. Obviously, with his legs, you know, almost 100 yards rushing for him on the evening. I thought that was going to be a key component for really the success of them, especially in those third down, three areas where he could kind of get himself mobile and get himself some first downs. And with that big run, that was a good start for him. You know, penalties were a bit of an issue in this game. A lot of them, honestly, Eric, were on third down. And that was a crucial part of, you know, stopping the Broncos and getting the ball back. But you're giving them more opportunities, and that keeps the defense on the field and your offense off. So that's never a good thing. And then finishing in the red zone. You have to finish in the red zone. Opportunities were there. You know, you found yourself in third and manageable situations, but when it counted and you needed it, you weren't able to come up. So, you know, listen, it was a hard-fought game, but, you know, ultimately you have to be able to execute in those money-down situations and take advantage of the turnovers that you're able to get in the game. And you didn't put up touchdowns. You kicked field goals, and that was the difference in the game.
I thought Pierre Desir's night was symbolic for the entire team. He gave up a couple touchdowns. He had a pair of interceptions and a pick six.
Listen, it's not easy to play corner in the NFL. And, you know, if you're on social media, you're probably seeing how everybody thought he had a terrible game. And then all of a sudden he becomes a hero. You have to have a short-term memory. And he did in that football game. But those plays in the second half of the game were huge. The pick six was huge. Gave the life and momentum to the Jets in those moments. Weren't able to convert the two-point conversion. But, again, getting yourself in the game, you got to find ways to score. Offensively, you couldn't finish in the red zone, so the defense was able to pick it up in the second half and make this a ball game. It was going to come down to the end of the game, and they weren't able to capture those moments.
What did you make of the Jets offensively? You talked about Sam Darnold really giving this team a jolt early in this ball game, and Jameson Crowder comes back to the lineup. He goes over 100 yards receiving for a second consecutive game, and I thought Jeff Smith really performed well. 7 catches, 81 yards.
Yeah, well, you know, I think we all expected Crowder to bounce back and be the target Sam wanted in this football game. He leaned on him a bunch of times throughout the game. I'll tell you what, Jeff Smith's a player now. I like this kid, and I think if you watch him on film and they start breaking things down, he's going to get implemented more in this offense as you move on. Just a heck of a job by him. I was really impressed by his skill set and just the calmness of the way he played the game tonight. It was really fun to see for him.
A wild night at MetLife Stadium, and unfortunately, the Jets fall again. They're 0-4 on the season, but they'll have a mini bye this weekend. As always, Anthony, we appreciate your analysis.